So you're behaviour support, yeah?
Yeah, so I am a team leader for behaviour support here in Fishwick.
Yep. What drives you? So what motivates you to get up every day and do the work you do? Mm-hmm. What's your drive?
For me, it's the individual client work that we do and just working with people one-on-one and figuring out what are their goals in life, what would make them the most happy, and really, like, no two clients are ever the same. It's always going to be this strategy will work with this client, but it won't work with this one unless we adjust it this way.
Yep.
That's always a bit of a challenge to kind of work through, and it's one that I appreciate having the challenge to do that while also getting people to where they want to be.
Mm. What's the thing that you love the most about your job?
The thing that I love the most is I just love seeing the smile on clients' faces when they finally get something, or just the small thanks that you get from a family member of, like, I saw my kid actually stop and think and ask first before doing this. It was amazing. And I'm just like, well, that's great to hear. I'm so glad that we're able to see that small sort of progress. So anytime there's a small baby step, I celebrate those small wins every day.
Yeah. Have you got your best client story to go with that, or?
For me, I have quite a few client stories, quite a few success stories, quite a few struggle stories, but I think the main one that comes to mind right now is there's a story, I would say, with my client yesterday was one of those small wins that I love. And so with her, she's 23, ASD level 3, lots of aggressive behaviors towards herself and others. And working with her within the past year, it used to be where she would get so escalated, she couldn't even talk about what was going on. Mm. And she would just end up hurting herself, and then she'll feel pain and hurt herself later on. And it just becomes a whole cycle. Mm. With yesterday, we were going through a social story, and during the story, she was able to say, wait, I did something I shouldn't have done. That was bad. I shouldn't have done that. I can ask for help first. I can take a deep breath. I'm sorry. And so she asked if she can say sorry to her carer. I was like, yes, go ahead, say sorry. And so her carer was able to get that bit of apology and see that she was recognizing that what she's doing is not helpful, mm-hmm. but she is working on it. So there's definitely many, many, many more steps to go. It's nothing that's going to change overnight, but within the past year and a half, she's finally gained that insight. And it's just one of those things that, like, even though it's going to be a long ongoing process, those small wins,
the
I love
start
those.
Of the steps. Yeah. Yeah.
Every day.
A small win is still a win in my books.
That's exactly.
Right. Take any win you can get, right, lads?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So what, do you have a guilty pleasure? What would your guilty pleasure be?
Ooh, my guilty pleasure, I have to say KFC chips.
Oh.
We don't have that in the US.
Really?
Yeah, no, KFC doesn't have chips, or what we would call french fries, up until probably right before I moved here. Usually they only have mashed potato, corn on the cob,
yep.
potato wedges, just recently battered fries, but it's nothing like the chips here.
Wow.
The chips with the chicken salt.
Oh,
so
the
good.
The smell just gets me going.
And
yeah.
it's just like, oh, it's my favorite. Also, chicken salt. Oh my God.
Yeah. You're making me hungry just talking about it.
I know.
Larry's got a guilty pleasure for KFC chicken nuggets.
Yeah.
Everywhere we go, he makes me stop to get nuggets.
Well, it looks like this is me right over here if you guys want to
drop
me off here.
We'll pull over right over here and let you out.
Trav and Larry, better than Uber.
Oh, thank you.
More expensive.
Yeah, we cost a fortune.